गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम फॉर टुडे सेशन. इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग टू कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर. व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट इन्फ्लुएंस व्हाइल अ कस्टमर इज परचेजिंग एनी प्रोडक्ट गुड्स, दैट इज गुड्स सर्विसेज आइडिया और नॉलेज. नाउ मूविंग फर्दर, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंडस्ट्रियल बाइंग बिहेवियर. Similar like consumer buying behavior, industrial buying is also affected by certain factors, and studying those factors are called as industrial buying behavior. Though there is a difference between industrial buying and consumer buying. Generally, for example, a customer is final end user for whatever purchase he is make. While industry is not a final end user customers. Further, in consumer purchase, transportation, communication, etc. are lesser involved as compared to industrial buying behavior, wherein the various services like transportation services, communication, then public utilities, even banking, finance, these all are factors are also included in industrial buying behavior, and those factors directly or indirectly may influence the buying behavior of customer. So let us firstly see what is industrial buying behavior. Industrial buying behavior, or it is also called as organizational buying behavior, is the process by which a company or any organization establishes a need for purchase of product and services, then identify, the evaluate and choose among alternative brands and suppliers. Similar like customer, identify the need, then they evaluate the various parameters and then choose amongst the alternate brands, alternate providers available to him. Similarly, in industrial buying behavior also, a company identify firstly need, what raw material or component they need, then identify who all are the suppliers of this component or material, then they evaluate on the basis of various parameters, and then choosing amongst the best available alternative for continuous supply of raw material and other components. So industrial buying behavior is studying how a company identify their need, then choose and evaluate the alternatives available to them. That is called as industrial buying behavior. Moving further, before starting the process of how industry is doing purchase process, or how it is affected, what is the behavior of buying, let us firstly understand how industrial market and consumer market both are different with each other. So here is aspect on which the difference is made for industrial market and for consumer market. Industrial buying behavior and consumer buying behavior, how it is different on various parameters. The first is buying objective. The objective of industrial buying is to enable the production. For whatever production company is established, their objective of purchasing anything is to enable the production, to support the production. Whereas the in customer market, the objective is to satisfy the personal need, that is need of any basic need or any need which is influenced by the external factors. The objective of customer purchase is satisfying own need, while the industry market, they don't want to satisfy their need, but they want to support their production. The next is buying motive. Mainly rational buying is done, that is any purchase is made after considering some specific process and logic, while The customer purchase are supported by many of time it is supported by emotional, rational as well as emotional. Say for example, purchase of life insurance, purchase of medical insurance, there are some logic in buying as well as there are some emotions attached for buying the insurance. The emotion is that after the death of any person, there other family members do not get financially paralyzed and hence the insurance is purchased. So here the rational is the rational and emotional, both are both logic are there, both motives are there. Now moving ahead, purchasing function. Generally the purchasing function in industrial market is performed by professional buying. There are some professional people involved in industrial buying, while the in consumer market the consumers itself themselves are the involved and they are not the professional buyers. They not buy on a professional way. Then the decision making in industrial buying, at a time of decision making many people are involved, a lot of discussion has been made and analysis has been done and then a buying a decision has been taken. While generally in consumer market many customers are not involved, the process is not so long, but however at a time of purchasing customer may consult with the other customers, those who have already used the product. After taking the feedback from them, the purchase decision is made. Then the characteristics, generally industrial buying is characterized by negotiation, intense interaction, many interaction, negotiation, many rounds of negotiation, negotiation on the basis of some payment terms, in other terms and conditions, etc. While in consumer market, the discussion rounds of interactions are less and customer directly go to market. They have already decided what they want to purchase and they directly go to market, purchase and with a little interaction they complete their buying process. While in industrial buying, from beginning to end many people are involved and they continuously interact with each other. Even after purchasing is made, they are interacting with each other. Then the product and market knowledge. In industrial buying, those people who are involved are having a larger knowledge of market and product, while the customer has very customer may have a limited knowledge regarding market and product. The order size, of course in industrial market generally the order size is very large as compared to customer market. In customer market the order size is quite less. Then comes demand. Generally the demand is derived demand and it is fluctuating as per customer as per production capacity. If the production capacity increases, the demand is also increases and vice versa. While the consumer market, the demand is autonomous, that is independent demand, not influenced by any other person, as well as relatively the demand is stable relatively as compared to industrial market. However, there may be a chance that consumer demand is also fluctuating. Then the price elasticity, generally in industrial market very less or almost no price elasticity is there, as their aim is to support the production, while as in consumer market many products are highly price elastic. It means if there is a customer is highly price elastic and for them the price is one of the biggest concern. Then the number of customers in industrial market, the number of customers are very limited. While in consumer market the customer base is very large. And then comes the spread of customer. The last point is spread of customers. Generally for industrial market the customers are spreaded across the large geographical area, though the number of customers are very small, but the customers may be spreaded across the large geographical area. Say for example, if a person is producing industrial bearings, then the users of industrial bearings are very limited company, but they may be located in Gujarat, they may be located in some Punjab, Haryana, Kerala, Rajasthan, Assam, etc. So all these everywhere the companies which want to use industrial bearings are located, but still they are very limited in number. Whereas in consumer market, the large customer base is very large, as well as they are spreaded in the large geographical area. Whereas in industrial market, the sometimes the customers are in large concentrated on the large geographical area. So they are spreaded in the large area, but they are concentrated. You can find those customer at a limited place. Whereas the customer market, they are spreaded, they also spreaded in large area, but they are not concentrated, they are scattered in a large geographical area. So for industrial buying, the customers are concentrated in the large geographical area, whereas in consumer buying, the customers are scattered in the large geographical area. So that is the difference between the consumer market and industrial market. Again, however, there are many differences at some point of time. The consumer buying and industrial buying are similar. So the rationale behind the buying is same. The process followed are almost a similar type of process. Here in industrial buying, the company identify their needs, identify various providers, then evaluate and then purchase. Similar is done in consumer buying behavior. So that is all about today's session. Have a nice day. Goodbye.